Well, thank you very much, Professor Sabar, for this most entertaining and truly informative lecture. And yes, I will consider moving to Jerusalem.
Okay.
But for the time being...
My assistant.
Yeah, absolutely. For the time being, we will focus on Jewish amulets from Eastern and Southeastern Europe. My paper will focus on parallels between Jewish amulets and charms of the mingling cultures in Southeastern Europe, predominantly in Italy and on the Balkans. In my view, a look into Jewish material culture covers its historical and anthropological entity only if surrounding influences are considered, like Ludwig Blau already did in his book on ancient Jewish magic in 1898. The main points I will cover are the following: formal and material aspects, textual points of contact, mythological and anthropological parallels. On this last point, I will apply psychoanalytic theory to gain a deeper understanding of unconsciousness, suppressed fears and desires, which give rise for superstitious ideas. Superstition and demonology was, and partly still is, particularly widespread in Southeastern Europe due to Kabbalistic influences and popular beliefs in Judaism, but also interactions with the neighboring people and religions. Eastern Europe, and especially the Carpathian region and the Balkans, are the home of various cultural groups which caused major mutual impacts on popular beliefs and magical rituals. Holy names and verses play the most important part in Jewish and Muslim magic, partly also in Christianity. Using names of God or angels for magical purposes has its roots in antiquity, as the name represents the essence of the named being. Furthermore, Christians use pictures of God, Jesus, Mary and angels, as well as crosses, but also excerpts from the Bible, prayers, incantation spells and magical symbols like numbers or the Star of David like in Judaism. Little boxes made of wood or metal picturing saints of the Orthodox Church held reliques or prayers, similar to tefillin or mezuzot in Judaism or textual amulets in Islam. According to ethnographical research, in times of danger, one tended to seek help not only from the expert of one's own religion, as for example, Sephardic Jewesses in Bosnia also consulted Muslim scholars when facing complications during pregnancy. Most popular are birth amulets, which in Judaism deal almost exclusively with the demoness Lilith, as thought of as nocturnal seductress of men, threat to women who give birth and to their babies, and vampire. Inner aggressions and tensions, which develop due to suppressed libidinous wishes because of religious restrictions, norms, and prohibitions of society, are released through Lilith. As nocturnal seductress of men, the male erotic fantasies are projected into the myth of the figure of Lilith, making her, the female, responsible for nocturnal discharge of semen, one of the most dangerous sins. As such, Lilith is also associated with Samuel Satan and diseases like diphtheria and leprosy, which is in turn reflected on amulets. A quotation from the circle of the Baal Shem Tov, the founder of Hasidism, clearly points out, quote, "When a woman begins to fantasize about a man, a fantasy about the woman arises in the man. And when the woman is modest and doesn't fantasize about the man, he doesn't fantasize either," unquote. This paper cut pair of Jewish birth amulets belongs to the Jewish Museum Vienna. Hanging on the walls of the bedroom, they also served as artworks in the folkloristic sense of Eastern Europe. Illustrated with watercolors and gold leaf, only traces of which are still visible, they date back to the second half of the 19th century. These amulets are stylistically very close to an example in the Jewish Museum of Switzerland in Basel, which is described as coming from the village of Hust in the East Carpathians. The iconography, full of animal and flower symbolism, can also be found on secular folk art and textiles from these regions. Catholics on the Balkans prefer a text called San Svete Bogodice, Dream of the Holy Mother of God, as an amulet. This text mentions also the characteristics which belong to the devil: nightmare, plague, unclean air, witch, infection, poisonous, vampire, to gulp. Only female nouns are used, as well as a lot of parallels to the characteristics of Lilith. I also want to present a textual amulet used among Sephardic Jews in Bosnia. Quotation: protect him from all evil, from fear and harm, from evil phenomenon, unclean air, those of male and female sex, nightmares, epilepsy, concussion and madness, evil eyes, all sorcery, imprisonment, the binding of magical knots. He should enjoy success in all his actions and operations. Unquote. One easily sees the two-way influences among the religious confessions, also to be found in another example from the Roma people. The female demon of Bibi, an expression for aunt, is the subject of a specific cult among the Roma of former Yugoslavia. She is both goddess and demon. A lot of Roma people worship her as the mother of all Romas. Those who refrain from offering hospitality to her will suffer from her evil spells. She is also identified with particular illnesses like Lilith, mainly of epidemic nature, as a threat for non-Romani children. Since 1888, a special holiday has been devoted to her. Icons of her are worshipped, and a special cake, which is given to the children, shall protect them as a sort of amulet. This belief is also shared by the Serbs, but under a different name. It is the plague, pestilence, or cholera, as female personification, wandering through villages to strangle children. These women are called either Juma for plague, meaning godmother, or Tetka, another expression for aunt, for cholera. In Italy, Jewish birth amulets exceed the magical aspect, as they are considered a status symbol, often produced by prestigious Christian silversmiths. This Italian amulet box even held the parchment with the very same text as in the mezuzah inside, referring to the protective character of the mezuzah. In Italy, birth amulets were used also among the nobility and the upper classes, no matter of which religion. From a formal and material point of view, I want to emphasize the parallels between Italian Jewish birth amulets and Italian amulets in general. Italian Jewish birth amulets are normally placed in an amulet box of a heart shape, made of silver or gold, most of them showing temple implements and iconography. The heart shape can also be found in Italian Catholic amulets, for example, from Sicily. The following comparisons show the heart form used for amulets in general between a Jewish birth amulet from Italy, from the collection of the Jewish Museum in London, and abitini, to which I will come presently, as well as so-called borsette, heart-shaped packet bound in cloth, containing, among other things, three grains of incense, salt, olive leaves blessed on Palm Sunday, prepared by nuns in a convent. In Calabria, these borsette are fastened upon an infant's left shoulder to protect it against witches and the evil eye. Italian popular tradition preserved an additional baptism at the crib, after the one at the baptismal font in the church. On the evening of the very same day, the family gathers around the crib seven chairs for the seven fairies that will come to bless the crib, the baby, and his cloths, using the purifying water from a basin. In Lucania, during the ceremony, the abitino is also baptized while hung from the baby's neck, a little cloth bag associated with the amniotic membrane, of which it represents the symbolic continuation. In Colobraro, these abitini were worn even by adults at least during significant moments in life. In Italy, a particularly important apotropaic function against the evil eye was attributed to the coral. This mineral is most popular in child amulets in Italy in general, mainly as a protection against the evil eye. It also helps against all diseases of the blood, probably also due to the analogy in the color. Phallic amulets, also often made of coral, played a talismanic role in Jewish and Roman antiquity. These amulets, predominantly in the form of the horn symbol in Italy as a phallic iconography protecting the liquids of life and procreation, are also to be found on Renaissance paintings around the neck of the Christ child. Jesus here serves as a figure of identification in need of protection, like the children of human beings, which are still used to this custom in the south of Italy today. In Marriage of St. Catherine by Andrea Previtali, the shape of the coral branch worn by the infant Jesus is strikingly close to the old Roman phallic charm. As a Jewish example, I'm presenting this Italian birth amulet of very popular form for this geographical region, also partly made of coral. Once caught, the evil eye needs to be removed by exorcism. The old woman of the Italian village, La Vecchia or La Strega, would diagnose if the indisposition was indeed caused by the evil eye. If so, she would exorcise the malocchio with a particular ritual using salt, water, olive oil and incantations, adding a Christian cover by Gesacca Maria to this pagan belief and crying out Che buozzi schiatta, may you break in pieces, similar to Kara Satan or Kara Lilith on Jewish birth amulets. According to the ideas of psychoanalysis in children, Melanie Klein pointed out that the child divides his mother in a good and a bad version, one who feeds on demand without any condition and one who doesn't, making her a witch according to infantile pre-eatable fantasies. The baby also forms two parts of his own good and bad selves, the loving one and an opposite version for all forms of negative emotions. According to Stein, quote, the evil eye can be understood metaphorically as a spat out introject, an externalized, repudiated bad self and bad mother. It is not I who envy, I would never do such a thing. There are evil-eyed ones out there to envy me, unquote. Like the Lilith complex, the evil eye serves to shift individual responsibility resulting from pre-eatable anxieties of destruction and separation. The evil eye system can thus be considered a cultural defense mechanism for handling the return of the repressed. Parallels can also be drawn between the customs in a tzaddik's court and annual pilgrimages made by Christians to holy places. One common aspect among these customs is the circulation of pictures of saints, also in the form of icons or miniature sculptures. Contemporary examples of Jewish birth amulets show portraits of famous rabbis. Belonging to an image cult similar to the portable versions of icons which are worn on the person, kept in the home, or carried by the devotee while traveling. The treatment of such portrait amulets allows to draw parallels with icons of the Eastern Orthodox Church, for they serve the same purpose. The holy person pictured, or his name written on an object, acting as a mediator for the communication of the individual with God. As Walter Benjamin stated in his The Work of Art in the Age of Mechanical Reproduction, the reproduction serves as a substitute for an individual believer in his particular situation. The reproduction reactivates the reproduced original object or person cult. Jane Garnett and Javier Rosa also refer to the social interaction as another basis how such cults work, including the circulation of miracle stories which are intrinsic to the construction of a cult and can easily be applied also to Hasidic storytelling as well as the mystical atmosphere at the tzaddik's court. Medals brought from holy Christian shrines, often of a miraculous Madonna icon, are also used as protection and talisman, similar to the Shmirot coins in the Hasidic context. Coins are in general valued due to their ascribed protective character against the evil eye, to disturb the gaze of envy. The substance character applies also to shirayim, the food leftovers of the tzaddik at the tish, which is similar to paste fishes, which were sold outside Italian churches, especially for children and against the evil eye. Significantly, the symbol of the fish seems to be a universal protection against the evil eye in various cultures. Similar psychological phenomena are votive offerings, which are extremely popular among Italian Christians until the present, comparable to Kvitlach in the Hasidic world. Behind these objects, both handed in to the saint / tzaddik, lays the need for help in specific situations of an individual's life. Ex votos are either little pictures showing an incident or silver shaped as body parts which are vulnerable due to particular illnesses or accidents. A vow is made to the pilgrimage site or a particular Madonna to offer something in return for the help in this case. The quittal, on the other hand, is a written appeal to the tzaddik to interfere in a situation. Italian ex voto very often have the form of a heart, referring in these cases mainly to the common belief and cult of the heart of Jesus, his suffering and strength, but also reminding us of other Italian and Jewish Italian amulets. This brings us back to the psychoanalytic approach. The existential fears expressed in popular beliefs are universal to mankind. These basic ideas, combined with threatening, life-changing situations during rites of passage, suppressed emotions in rural peasant surroundings, as well as limited access to educational and professional medical support, are explanations for the use of amulets. There are counter-influences throughout the mixture of various people living together, especially in South and Eastern Europe. The use of amulets is a living tradition, especially among Hasidic Jews, who have brought amulets from Eastern Europe to Israel and the New World. I've only shown a few striking examples in my presentation today. The question of the geographically rooted and enhancements of Jewish amulets from Eastern Europe deserves further research. We need to apply a comparative approach regarding parallels and touch points with Islam, Catholicism, the Eastern Orthodox Church, Roma traditions, and other ethnic groups, as well as Sephardic and Ashkenazi rituals on the Balkans, if we wish to gain a full understanding of Jewish popular beliefs in South and Eastern Europe. Thank you for your attention.